Hi friends, thanks for joining us again. We are here learning how to use Figma as a product person. We're trying to learn how to visually communicate using Figma enough that we can create a lightweight prototype to share with our team. Last week we learned all about file creation, structure of files and libraries, and then this week we've been learning about components, styles and variables, and today we are going to dig into shapes and images. With that, we'll be talking about how to create those shapes, how to edit them, and how to bring in images or other assets that we have. So Lauren, thank you for being here. Thank you for teaching us again. And where do we start with shapes?
You bet. We're gonna pop into our lesson three over here. We're just gonna keep using our lesson three from now on. I think we've got a couple of things created already in here, but let's start off now talking about some shapes. So where would we even grab those shapes? To get our shapes, we're gonna go in the top nav over to our left, and this is where our shape tools live. So rectangle, I feel like that's gonna be one that you're gonna use a lot. Ellipse is gonna be a handy one. The star one is interesting to just see how those angles can change and how those points can change. So we'll talk about that. And then we'll talk about getting some images inside of all of these. So let me create a rectangle. Awesome. And if I hold down, a lot of times you're going to want a perfect square or a perfect circle, not an oval or anything like that. So if I hold down the shift T as I'm creating this, so I'm just dragging out, that's going to create it as a perfect square or a perfect circle. And I'm going to go over here and just change the fill so it's a little bit easier to see. And a couple of things that we can do with this now. We can round the corners, which I feel like you're going to find a lot on your design. So we can do that a couple of different ways. We can either go right up here to our right-hand side, and I can just start to, I can type in the number, or I can just use the arrow keys. I'm doing an increments of 8 right now. And as I do this, you see the corners are changing. And actually, we can even turn this into a circle now. This is how I get a lot of my circles, just starting out with rectangles and changing the quarter radius until it goes up enough so that the corners are basically gone. The other way is you can see now all those corners are now like to the center, but there's this one little circle in the middle here, this little icon. And if I drag those out, now I can drag the corner radii again. So I can do that this way, or I can do it from, and you can watch over here that it's changing as well. We can also do, if you only want one corner to be rounded, that's where you're gonna go to the independent corners over here. Very independent, our corners. And we can change those one by one. So say we wanted 0, and 14, and let's do
free the corners
200. Yeah, and
cool.
We'll do 10.
So you can really start to get something pretty custom, right?
Exactly
there.
Yeah, and this is all just starting from a rectangle, so lots you can do here. Let's grab our star tool, because this one's kind of fun to play around with the count on here and to play around with the angles and the ratio here. So if, and again, same thing, these we can do, we can play with on our right hand side in the panel here if you want to put in a very specific number, but you can also just play around by grabbing these little circles within.
Cool.
And changing it here. We can round the corners here.
Wow.
We can change how many angles there are here. So almost like creating like a badge shape. And let me make sure the color is a little bit easier to see here. And all of this started with a star. So you can create lots of different unique shapes from the shapes that are provided for you.
Wow. So we also do things like, so we change the fill. Can we also change things like the outline or the...
Yeah, absolutely. So we can add in a stroke right here. So let's, similar to how we added that in with the style. So we can even pull color styles for our stroke. We created that purple style last time. I'm going to change the stroke on here now. And we can change it to the center, to the outside. That's going to have a big impact on how this looks. When it's inside, it's all obviously inside of that shape. Versus when it's outside, it has a totally different look to it. And I'm going to just duplicate this here to look at the difference here, inside versus outside. So it gives it a totally different look there. We can also add some images into here, which can be really handy if you want an avatar of yourself or something in maybe our check-in flow or our sign-up flow. We can add images right into here. So we can do that a couple of different ways. Let's start with our, I don't know what shape this is anymore, our fun square. Let's start with this one. I can go into my fills and I can, a couple different things, I can change it to a gradient, but what we want is an image. We can also do video too. So I can choose the image just right from here. I can grab, I'm going to do this little adorable duck. There he is, our adorable little duck. And let's actually give him a stroke because it'll be a little bit easier to see. So I want a black stroke and I want 10. Okay, great.
Okay.
Couple things with this image here. I want him to be a little bit more centered. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna double click And I'm gonna change around my fill versus fit versus crop versus tile. So by default, okay, it's gonna go to fill. If I changed it to be fit, that means it's going to fit the entire image. So fill worked a little bit better for us because it's filling the whole shape, but it's still cropping some things off. And as we are changing the size of this, so I'm just changing all things around, it's still filling the whole shape. So I want the whole duck here, but I want it to be more of this size. So what I'm gonna do now is go to crop, and that's gonna allow us basically to see our whole image behind, but I can move this up to be exactly where I want it.
Yay, hi,
and
Ducky.
Now click off. And there he is, he's so cute. A couple other ways of resizing. So if you are just clicked on here, obviously this is going to change it whichever way you move it. I'm going up, I'm going left. If say I really mean to change the size of this, I want this to be a little bit shorter, but I don't want the fill to change here. I don't want the duck to size as it would be if I'm doing it this way. If I hold down command and drag this up, now I'm able to really resize my shape, but not impact the image behind it. And again, I can click in now and move this over a little bit. I can even from here, if I decide that I wanna change this size, do it from here, do it that way too. So lots of different options within here.
Very exciting. There's so much power here, what you can do just by using those options of the fill, the strokes, the colors, those gradients that you showed, and then also all of these image options here. Mm-hmm. So much power. How exciting. Are there any other effects, Lauren, that you often use with shapes that we might want to bring in here?
Yeah, actually, so we could do effects literally right down here. That's one fun way to add in something like a drop shadow, and we can change that by going into here, making it a little bit darker so it's a little bit easier to see. I can change kind of the location of it. There we go.
Change
the blur. So that can be really handy. We also have under drop shadow, we can do a layer blur, a background blur, an inner shadow. So lots of different effects that could happen right down here in the effects area.
Very cool. Again, so much power there. And it looks like with each of those on the right, what I'm seeing is seems like we can add in more of those options like you did with the shape, where we can add multiple fills or multiple strokes or multiple effects.
Yep.
It sounds like we can do that. Wow.
Yep. You can definitely layer
them. Lots of power there. But I think we have done it. We have learned the basics of using shapes and images here. So if we just go back and check in with what we've learned, we learned about creating a shape. We learned about types of shapes, both starting with something simple like a rectangle or starting with something complex and creating a badge image. I never thought I'd be able to create some type of badge shape like that. That's cool. And it was fairly simple using that star. That's great.
Mm-hmm.
Then we edited our shape. We didn't talk about the pen tool. Do we briefly want to talk about what that pen tool is and how we can use it?
Yeah, so the pen tool is really great for if you're creating super simple icons or if you wanted your own custom shape to add these images into or just use that, you'd be able to find right up here next to our shape tool, and you could grab the pen tool right up here.
Awesome. Makes sense. For our purposes, we'll probably won't be creating anything too custom. We'll stick to those shapes and images that we have, but it's good to know it's there and we can do something more custom if we needed to. And then we did learn about images and cropping as well. So we have the basics that we need to know. What I'm going to do from here, Lauren, is I'm going to take a homework assignment to put this all together, what we've learned of libraries, components, styles, and then now our shapes and images. And I'm going to come back to you next time with a first kind of foray of our sign up flow using all of these components. Does
that
sound good?
Yeah, that sounds great. I'm excited to see it.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Lauren.
Cool.
See you tomorrow.
You bet. See you later.